This video takes you on a brief tour of the new I-35E corridor between University Avenue in St. Paul and Little Canada Road in Little Canada. We'll work our way northward. Long-awaited reconstruction and rehabilitation of the Interstate 35E corridor begins in spring 2013. Completion of the nearly 4.5 mile long project will take place by late 2015. When completed, the project also will feature MinPass express lanes in both directions of I-35E, alongside the 3 lanes of general purpose traffic. As we make our way north, you'll see we're replacing the bridge over Pennsylvania Avenue, the bridge spanning Cayuga Street, and the bridges spanning the railroad. The freeway itself will be shifted several hundred feet to the east near Cayuga Street. We're replacing the current interchange at Pennsylvania Avenue with a full access interchange at Cayuga Street. Moving freeway access from Pennsylvania Avenue to Cayuga Street will improve safety and reduce congestion while lessening delays and providing better freeway access for St. Paul's Phelan Boulevard corridor. In addition, the project includes extension of the Gateway Trail, which currently terminates at Cayuga Street, all the way to University Avenue. The project also will provide trails to connect the Gateway Trail and the Vento Trail along Cayuga Street. We've already completed a sizable amount of work north of Cayuga Street by replacing the Maryland Avenue Bridge spanning I-35E during summer 2012. As we continue northward, we'll note new bridges spanning the interstate at Arlington Avenue, Wheelock Parkway, and Larpenteur Avenue. Ramp access to and from Interstate 35E at the Wheelock Parkway and Larpenteur Avenue interchange will remain as it is today. The bridges at Roselawn Avenue and County Road B also will be replaced with new, wider bridges. Ramp access to and from Interstate 35E at the Roselawn Avenue interchange will also remain as it is today. The I-35E bridges spanning Highway 36 will be replaced, but the existing loops and ramps at the Cloverleaf will remain, with certain modifications to help aid merging traffic. As we continue our trip northbound to Little Canada Road, we see driving surface reconstruction continue, as has taken place on the entire segment of 35E, with an unbonded concrete overlay that provides a smoother, longer-lasting surface. Additional information on the I-35E corridor project is available on the web at www.mndot.gov. MinPass information is also available on the web at www.minpass.org.